Oh, you can try and remember.
I just made that before you heard it and then liked it, and then I had to really remember it. It was
This is one of my favorite songs of Eric's.
Well, I remember now.
And I was trying to help you there. Like, this is you want to introduce it? I really want to go to this place that he wrote this song about. Someday, it's gonna happen. It's called the General Store.
My problem is I'd like to do a tour someday so that we could go visit places like this.
The General Store tour?
But I don't want to go. I don't, like, you don't tour in Northern Maine.
You can go through, man.
It's like 6 hours off from everything.
Yeah, but it's worth it to go to the General Store. Where they have furniture and ammo.
Wolverines and moose have very little disposable income, I hear.
It's crazy. Have we been up here for 20 minutes and not played a song?
Okay.
Thank you.
They sold you almost everything you own before you buy the final sailor stone. Before you buy the final sailor stone. Before you buy the final sailor stone. At the general store. At the general store. This to our beautiful hostess this evening. I wrote this song a while back. I wrote it like this sounds really like I might have made this up, but I didn't make this up, I promise you. It was It was 3 days before Hurricane Harvey hit. And I was in my bedroom and I felt real heavy, or maybe 2 days, I felt the pressure. And I came up with two lines, which were the first two lines of the song. And it was, the wind has changed, there's a storm a-coming now. And I just left it, I just completely forgot about it and I never went back to it. And then the hurricane hit and I was like, shit, I need to finish this song. So I did, I finished it and it was basically just the thought of it's called Up. It's just about, you know, going up, whatever that means to you, whether going up in life or in your career, or just like a balloon, whatever you want. But I got really fortunate recently that these two filmmakers approached me about it, and they were like, hey, is there any chance we could make a music video for you for your Up song, because we really like it? And I was like, yeah, sure. And they were like, so we've come up with an idea. They were like, you're really in love with Austin, aren't you? And I was like, yeah, we both are, Ben and I, another Ben in my musical duo. And they were like, we'd really like to make a music video that was basically like a love letter / just a respectful kind of homage to how much you feel for Austin, Texas. So they did it and we got to record it at Green Hall, and we had two actors come in, and it's gonna be coming out very soon. And they basically just built this story and made the song way deeper than I ever made it. But yeah, it's going to come out soon and we're going to dedicate it to Karen. So this is awesome. Yeah. There's a storm coming now. There's a rattle in my bones. I hear the whisper in between the clouds, like a hand upon my throat. No backing out, this world is gonna show you what it's really made of. Swallow your doubt, wake up, it's only a matter of time. I wanna go up. Lift me up. Take me so far away. I wanna go up, up, up. Friday. Monday, it's like, I wanna go on. Lift me up. This depends on the day of the week.
Well, it's my turn again, folks, and it's time to kill someone.
Yeah!
Most of my songs are about heartbreak or murder. Those are the two topics I like the most, I think. One leads to the other. And I just, you know, I like the, I love tragedy, you know, the stories are pretty to me. And there's so many wonderful murder songs that have been birthed right here in Texas. And I, you know, being a northerner, I was like, well, you know what, we need to represent a little bit harder for the north. Because there aren't enough murder songs, you know, in Michigan and north, but Detroit and Flint have been having a hard enough time, so I figured I'd go farther north. I figured the French Canadians, they need a murder song. Well, and you know, I used to play, I made this whole story up, and it was something I'd been working on for a while, and it just was always in the back of my head for a long time, and then I was thinking about all the guys who I used to play hockey with, and all these the craziest people, the toughest people I ever played with was from this town called Chicoutimi in French Canada. And they were just the dudes who would spit their teeth back on the ice and not even put them in their pockets, you know, and just keep going. They were hardcore. So I made the heroine of this story from Chicoutimi. I hope you enjoy it. She was a lioness, a duchess of the dark, from Chicoutimi with her husband on her arm. He was a soldier, made his life in Montreal, proposed to her that winter neath the castle carnival. Well, their love quickly turned sour when he learned to use his hands against her moonlight body till she could hardly stand. She waited patiently until one fateful day. This is the story of Mariette du Maurier. Well, it was their anniversary 3 years ago this day, when he promised her a happy life and children they could raise. The last year dreams of children, well, they vanished by his fist, when his callous knuckles hit her and laid her wound to rest. Bonjour, my loving husband, Mariette, it's my own say, I've made for you this breakfast, let's celebrate this day. It was his favorite three eggs and corned beef hash, rat toast and apple butter, leftover succotash. On the pont de Trou.
she pranced down to the pond, and her husband followed close. Her steps were light and sure, while his were drunk and slow. He stumbled on that ice as his hands were slow and stiff. Mariette just danced ahead and teased him with her hips. Well, I hope you like that rum, she said. I was worried you'd suspect. Well, I guess it's just that poison takes some time to take effect. Story of Mariette du Maurier.